is the planar sphere here in the slums. We should climb the stairs and find some manner of entrance. If I'm right, my blood, my presence should open the sphere.
First, we have to get up the stairs. So what's this?
Cities always teem with evil and decay. Let's give it a good shake and see what falls out.
All right, so we have to go in here, I guess, and out through the side door. All right. I'm gonna draw the suspense out a little bit. I'll be right back, guys. See you in a second.
Yes?
Valigar, can I ask you something? A kind of personal question? What is the question? You can ask, though I may not answer. I understand you do not believe in the gods? I believe in them. Only a fool wouldn't. I don't worship them, however. But they created us. Don't you think we owe them? If you give someone a gift and say nothing of repayment at the time, would you ask for payment later? Of course not. No, most people would consider you quite petty if you did. Why should we mortals be held to higher standards than gods? If my life belongs to anyone or anything besides myself, then certainly I owe no one anything for it. I suppose that makes sense. But why would you wish to reject the gods? My faith kept me from going mad when I was in the circus. Now Baerûn comforts me with the knowledge that I am not alone and helps keep me on the path of good. Eri, what's it mean to believe in the gods? Certainly there are beings of great power, with their own skewed morals and supposed wisdom. At some level they are responsible for this world and everything in it, including me. But look at some of them, like Talos, Sirik, and Shar. Tell me that these gods are in any way morally superior to mortals. If there are evil gods, then gods are not necessarily good. If there are mad gods, then gods are not necessarily wise. If some gods are former mortals, then I need more reason to offer my worship than the simple fact that gods exist. It's been a long time since I needed companionship, and even with what I've learned since joining Sapphire, which hasn't been long at all, I have more faith in my own conscience than I would in the whims of some deity. I think I understand. Thank you for answering my questions, Valigar. Of course, Eri. Glad I could help. Alright. Now, to the matter at hand. If we can stop tripping over our own feet. Wow. Exit. This is an exit? That sounds scary.
Armored, live by the sword. Live
so
a
it.
Good long time.
In Baerûn's name,
destiny
shall
awaits.
Be done.
Jacques.
Yeah, protection from evil awaits as well.
Manus, potentis, paro.
I am ready, I think. I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
Evidently not trapped.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Oh. Well, that one needs to be turned.
All the world is blind. Passing.
Stand back for justice!
Let me guess, we don't We can't open this one.
All the world is blind to my passing.
We must move closer to examine the door panel. The door has a control panel on it, which appears to be missing a vital piece. Alright, we'll go this way.
Fleet of foot and all that.
I don't know if you can trap a portal, but... Oh, it's a door. It's just a cool looking door.
All the world is blind to my passing. All the world is blind to my passing.
Stepping through, there's a clay golem in there. And some chests. I forget. Golems can only be hurt by magic, or can only be hurt physically. It just seems to change from game to game.
All the world is blind. Passing.
A simple matter.
A simple matter? Let's see how it handles this. In Baravan's name, it shall be done. Magic resistance. Not injured.
Yoshimo is willing.
This. All right.
See, battle bow. Run, bow, run.
Fine.
You're gonna go over there? Okay.
Make way, villainy!
I'll do my
Hero
best.
Coming through!
Right, so let's... There's only one of them. I'm not gonna let anyone else near that thing, except for the fighters. Him, and him. Maybe Viconia. Maybe we'll keep her back. So I'm not gonna bother with magic. Yeah, what it's called? Mirror image or blur. I'm just going to get the haste going, especially for the fighter types. And then I guess a bless as well. Let's let that take effect. Jacules.
The bigger they are, the harder
You're
I
right
hit.
Behind me, right?
I can hear you well enough. I'll get on it right away.
Right away.
What do you? Very well. Hiya.
There it is.
Been as 40.
A good hit.
Yeah.
Oh, got it. Bolt of biting. Did I give him bolts of biting? I thought I gave him bolts of ice. I mean arrows of ice. Who's... Oh, he's using... I meant to have him on sword duty.
Yes, I did.
Well, that went well. Okay.
Nothing dangerous, I would hope.
Well, that's for you to determine. So it's just a room of goodies.
Memories in such a place as this. Most unpleasant memories.
Most unpleasant. Oh, just what we were looking for before. Bullets, these are plus two. Conjure lesser air elemental and minor spell turning. That reminds me. At level 12, he can kind of have minor spell turning. What's got coal? This is a pile of coal. A pound of coal, I guess. Too far away. Alright. Let's all get in here then.
Bad kicking for goodness!
We're gonna be trading some things, I'm sure. Bullet plus two. Okay. So he is level 12. Okay. He has access to priest. Oh, quite a few. He's up to third. Okay, so he's got cure light wounds, which is always good. I don't use bless that often. It runs out so quick. How about Doom? That's a good one. Flame Blade. Charming Bark Skin. Good Berry. No Alignment. Resist Fire and Cold. Slow Poison. We just bought like a whole bunch of antidotes. I don't think we're gonna need Slow Poison. That's actually not as good as, you know, 1d4. So, I mean, it's pretty good. Anywhere between, let's see, 2, 6 to 4, 5, 6, 10. Six to ten damage you can do with that. But 6 to 10 damage, right? This does. It has the slowing thing. And it does 3, 2. Right? So 1, 2, 3. Oh, wait, no. Plus 4. So you can. If you roll a 1, you get 5, 6, 7 damage. Versus, if you roll a 6, that's 10, 11, a 1d6 plus, yeah, plus 4, that's 5, no, it's 11, what am I talking about? So you get 6, plus 4, and 11, 12, 12 damage. Oh, and then here, I didn't even see the plus, yeah, so the Flame Blade is not even as good, it's like he would be underutilized if he used that over the Flail of Ages. So let's take that out of his spells. How about Barkskin? Resist fire and cold. 50% less around per level. Okay. Might never use it, but we'll see. Call lightning. I love it, but it only works outdoors. Cure disease. Cure medium. Dispel magic. Haste. Just saying he gets 3 spells at level 12. He got all this stuff. Technically 5. Summon insects. Ooh. That's good to use on mages. I might just have that one. Strength of 1. Rigid thinking. Which like... confuses people. Protection from fire only. Complete invulnerability. Unless it's a spell. In which case it's 80%. Alright, let's take this summon insects then. So we have to rest before it's available.
I can dance on the head of a bin as well.
Oh, that too. I'm surprised none of these things are trapped. That's why I keep looking. Okay, a scroll of polymorph other. And, bolts. Plus 1 bolts, I guess. I guess we have this one. Bolt plus 2. Oh, okay. Okay. All right, next.
You require my counsel, yes? Fleet of foot and all that.
No counsel required. Just looting. Okay, an emerald. Either plus 1 or plus 2 arrows and a scroll of haste. Plus 2. Those can go in there. I don't even know what we're looting. What is that? It's like a column or something? Or part of a column? Okay, we've got a golem arm. This is a long iron arm. It is useless without a body. Really? Oh, planar key. This thin bar vibrates softly in your hand. It looks as if it could be used as either a key or a lever. Oh, thank you. Scroll of Breach. We have bolts that are just plain old bolts, I guess. Plain bullets. Alright. You don't need the plain stuff. You keep the key. The golem arm is 25 pounds, so you can have that. Actually, I'll put it in the bag of holding. Alright, that's everything.
Whatever you need, I do it well.
I wanted to see what happened if he just stood there. Alright.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
So you have an arm of a golem. Are we gonna find more golem pieces?
Yoshimo is willing. All the world is blind to my passing.
And here we've got a steam method.
We have such stories amongst my people. Being underground is just not for the Avariel.
We can use this? What is this? Oh. This pool shows a bird's eye view of Athkatla. The planar sphere stands out like a magic beacon in the heart of the city.
You're right behind.
You hit us all.
Who says?
You stinker.
What? Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Oh, is she held or something? She's stunned. She's back, okay.
Now, Natha.
I was hoping it would come up close to the door and we could just
you
hit
point.
It.
I punch.
Where shall I display my skill and expertise?
Display it right here.
Your life shall be mine.
Okay.
Yeah, not bad at all.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
So it is, it's the slums. Huh, interesting. Alright. So what are we supposed to do about this other thing? This other door? Panel to open inner door. Hmm. Oh, meaning this is the exit of this. Ooh, you insert the lever and proceed to pull it. The control panel talked to us. It says you have initiated planar travel. The inner door will now open. You may not leave the sphere until the master allows it. The lights went out for a few moments. Then the ship rumbled. The ship? This thing is a ship?
Very well. Hiya.
Anakin. Someone by the name of Anakin over there.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Anakin, Reyna, and Anvo. And there's two doors out. Maybe they're friendly?
Swords, not words! Stand back for justice!
Standing back for
all
justice.
The world is blind.
Hello.
To my
you are welcome in my sight.
You're welcome. We're welcome in her sight. Stranger, identify yourself before you come any closer. Doesn't sound that welcome. Sapphire, it appears that I am as trapped as you and your companions. Trapped indeed. I am Reyna. I and my fellow knights of Salamnia, Anvo and Ankin have been imprisoned in this strange dungeon for a long time. That's awesome. They're the knights of Salamnia. I never know how to say it. From the Dragonlance campaign setting. Kryn. The land of Kryn. Knights of the Rose, they are. Knights of Salamnia? We are the Knights of Honor and Good upon Ancelon, a world so far removed from this one. I think Ancelon is the continent and Kryn is the planet. Or I have it reversed, I don't know. Are there any traps up ahead that I should be wary of? Traps? No, but in the dark rooms of this place I have witnessed horrors. These terrors I am loath to discuss, but if it helps your cause, then I shall. When we first arrived here, my fellow knights and I thought to explore our new surroundings. I wish we hadn't. To the west, we were ambushed by small creatures, children in size but not in appetite. We were hard-pressed to battle our way out of the trap. Small creatures, children inside. So they have a ravenous appetite, and they're small. Perhaps they were halflings? Halflings? Do halflings seek to rip and rend the flesh from your body? To swallow your flesh and suck the marrow from your bones? If so, then halflings they may be. No. They're not like that. But, the closest thing to halflings that they have in Dragonlance settings are Kender. Which are more mischievous and have a special hoopack weapon that they enjoy using. Which, if I have it right, is like a long stick combined with a sling or something like that. You must be careful if you encounter them. They are crafty and a worthy foe of any knight. Fare thee well. Huh. I have encountered three knights who call themselves Knights of Salamnia, who claim to be from a world named Ancelon. They have been trapped inside the sphere. Reyna, one of the Knights of Salamnia, warned of strange, ravenous, halfling-like creatures west of where they are. According to Reyna, the knights were barely able to fight their way out of a trap these creatures had set. Well, I wonder how we'll fare against them then. Hopefully this isn't their stuff. Let's see if Reyna has anything else to say. Greetings once more. It appears that the cannibalistic children have yet to make a meal of you. This is good. Cannibalistic children. Yeah, we'll get through this again. Alright.
All the world is blind to my passing.
So, Anvo, another knight.
Good day to you.
Is this place not frightening but wondrous at the same time? By my oath, I have never been to such an interesting domain. Well, yeah, actually makes sense, because it's a planar sphere, so we're traveling between the planes, so they got on from, I guess, the plane of Dragonlance setting. Excuse my rudeness. I am Anvo, Knight of the Sword. We are far from my homeland, trapped here much as you, I suspect. I think Knight of the Rose is the highest you can get. Knight of the Sword. I am a Knight of Salamnia. There are three orders of Salamnic Knights, Crown, Sword, and Rose. Reyna is a Knight of the Crown, and Ankin is a Knight of the Rose. Yeah, I think this is might be the order, actually. Or maybe Sword, Crown, and Rose. Thank you for the lesson, Anvo, but I must be going. Fare thee well. But we have more. Greetings again. What did you need? There were more Questions. Did you discover anything interesting? Past the bone room, you will find a chamber full of magical equipment. There is one large tube holding a damaged golem that is missing its head and arm. Oh, I think we have the arm. Whoever sought to repair it was interrupted in his work. Where's the bone room? Is that the with the little creatures? The magician's study reminds me of my brother Elik's room, back when he studied to become a wizard. That room, so alien, yet so familiar, stirs me the most. That said, there was a presence here that worried me. I did not scout further than that room. That sounds interesting. Perhaps I might explore that way. Fare thee well. Anvo, one of the knights of Salamnia trapped in the sphere, warned me of a wizard's room nearby that contains a damaged golem. So I don't know if this is to the west, with those other little creatures, or to the north. So finally we have Ankin, just checking to see if there's any question mark things, flavor text.
Good day to you.
Strangers be wary. This twisted hell shows no mercy to the weak of spirit. I am Ankin, Knight of the Rose. Do not worry about my spirit. I am more than capable of handling whatever dangers may be held within these walls. Your bravery is commendable, but the wiser woman often lives long past her more foolhardy comrades. May I offer you a little advice? I always welcome advice. Directly north, you will find a room. Within its walls is an oceanic nightmare. Fish that walk as men live there. Be wary if you walk that way. Oh, Kuotoa? Anything else? If I'm saying that right. Wisdom I hold much of, but I suspect you would rather not sit here for hours listening to my lectures. You are young and have an adventurous fire in your veins. You are not yet ready for true wisdom. Huh. Nice. Ankin, one of the knights in the sphere, warned me of an oceanic room to the north where fish walk as men, and that I should be wary if I go there. Wow. Alright, so we've got stuff to look forward to and stuff to avoid. There's some scroll called Kelbin's Warding Whip. Never heard of that one. And here's a gold necklace. Okay, I guess that's not their stuff. I'll take that. Kelbin's Warding Whip. Level 7 spell, wow. Lasts for 3 rounds. When this spell is cast, it dispels one spell protection of up to 8th level, affecting the target creature. Each round thereafter, till the duration of the spell expires, another spell protection will be removed from the target. I like it. The spells affected by Kelbin's Warding Whip are Minor Spell Turning, Minor Globe of Invulnerability, Spell Immunity, Globe of Invulnerability, Minor Spell Deflection, Spell Turning, Spell Deflection, and Spell Shield. They will always remove the highest level spell protection affecting the target. Good, I like that. If more than one same level protection is active on the target simultaneously, one of them will be randomly chosen and dispelled. The target's magic resistance, if any, does not affect this spell. Alright, attempting to scribe. And save scumming. They're the only save scumming I do, otherwise, you know, other than us being killed. Done. So it's 7th level. Okay. Has been added somewhere. Right there. Okay. Actually, calling an episode here. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Next episode will be the extra special 200th episode. We're going to be running for at least an hour and a half. More like two and a half hours. Typically. It's going to be a thing. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.